बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम डियर स्टूडेंट्स एंड व्यूअर्स अस्सलाम वालेकुम। दिस इज मोहम्मद शहीदुल इस्लाम बिफोर यू लेक्चरर इन इंग्लिश मेयन स्टैंडी मदरसा गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज टीटास कुमिल्ला। माय प्रेयर्स ऑलवेज विथ यू। आई प्रे टू अल्लाह फॉर यू, फॉर योर वेल बीइंग, फॉर योर गुडनेस एंड बेटरमेंट। सो आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेल बाय द ग्रेसेस ऑफ ऑलमाइटी अल्लाह। Today we will discuss on a topic, and this topic is completing sentence. To complete any incomplete sentence, you have to know tense, change of voice, right form of verb, and use of conjunction. Otherwise, it will be so difficult for us to complete any incomplete sentence. To reduce our time, already I have noted some sentences on whiteboard. So dear, come to the point. Number one, hardly had mother called me when. We know that hardly had mother called me, hardly had such a conjunction which bear third form of verb, and we are watching third form of verb. So another part will be when plus past simple tense, but when is here available. So we have to complete this sentence by using past simple tense. Hardly had mother called me when I came to her here. Subject plus second form of verb plus of the text, these are called past simple tense. After completing sentence, we must underline the part done by us. Number two, would you mind such a word which bear ing from verb next with it. And after completing, we have to use question mark. For example, would you mind talking with me and question mark. Number three, would you like use of would you like is little different from would you mind. After would you like, you have to use infinitive form, and after that question mark. We know infinitive means to plus verb equal to verb and noun. When to plus verb work as verb and noun, it is called infinitive. Would you like, after would you like, we must use infinitive form to complete this sentence. Would you like, we can complete by using previous sentence. Would you like to talk with me and question mark. The students, in number two, would you mind plus verb plus ing, but would you like, then you have to use to plus verb, that's mean infinitive form. Number 4, I give attention list. List such a conjunction. After that, you have to use subject plus should or might and base form of verb. I give attention list. For example, I should list to understand. List plus subject plus should plus verb base form plus of the text. We can use might against should. Number 5. As soon as mother called me. We know as soon as such a conjunction which bear two clauses. We know that the clause which is with conjunction, it is called subordinate clause. But we know that as soon as such a conjunction where both of the clauses are past simple tense. And here we are watching mother called me. Mother subject called second form of verb, that's been past simple tense. So we have to complete this sentence or we have to write another clauses in past simple tense. As soon as mother called me, I came. Number 6, she studied hard so that such a conjunction which is two part, if the previous part or the principal clause is present simple tense, to complete this sentence we have to use subject plus can plus base form of verb plus object extra. If the previous part or the principal clause is past simple tense, we have to use subject plus second form of verb plus object plus extra. We are watching here, she studied hard. She subject started second form of verb, that's mean it is past simple tense. Past simple tense plus so that plus subject plus could. So she studied hard so that she could get A plus. Subject plus could, base form of verb plus object plus extra. If the clause is in present simple tense, she is studying hard so that present simple tense plus so that plus subject plus can plus verb base form. Then we have to use she can get a plus. Number 7, I wish, I like, I fancy. These are sentences, not any conjunction, to expression anybody's personal view, personal thinking, personal wishes. I wish, I like, I fancy are used. Everybody use I like, I wish, I fancy to express his her expression, point of view, personal thinking, personal wishes. we have to remember that I wish, I like, I fancy. These are present simple tense. If these sentences are in present tense, then you have to use past simple to complete this sentence. And these sentences are in past simple, then you have to use past perfect tense to complete these sentences. But there is a note that if you use be verb, then you have to use were, beyond, watch. I wish, I like, I fancy. I were a teacher. Dear students, you may use could be beyond where. You may use could be beyond where. We are watching that I wish or I like or I fancy is the present simple or present tense. Then I used subject plus where plus object, past simple tense. You may have a question, where is it, where, beyond or instead of was. Already I have said that I wish, I like, I fancy. If the sentence is in present tense, then you have to use past tense. And there is a be verb, you have to use where instead of was. Okay? And you may use could be instead of where. There is no problem. You have to use where or could be if there is a present tense. But it is past simple. For example, wished. I liked, I fancied. You have to use past perfect tense. We see that these are past simple. So to complete this incomplete sentence, I or you have to use past perfect tense. We know that subject plus head, verb third form, is called past perfect tense. You have to use had been or could have been. This is the proper system for I wish, I like, I fancy. Number 8, it is time, it is high time, it is right time, it is proper time. In this field, we have to use past simple. Actually, it is time, it is high time, it is right time, it is proper time, these are present tense. Or it may have in present perfect tense, there is no problem. But if the sentences are, or the form of the sentence is in present tense, you have to use past tense or infinitive. It is time, I, STUDIED, studied. It is time, I studied. We know that after it is time, we must have used past simple tense or infinitive. If we use infinitive, then we know that infinitive means 2 plus verb works as verb and noun. It is called infinitive. 2 plus verb. It is time. After it is time, you may use past simple or infinitive. For example, I started subject plus second form of verb, past simple or 2 plus verb, infinitive. It was time. It was time is like it is time, but it is time present simple and it was time past simple. In this field, you have to use past perfect tense or infinitive. For example, I have studied or to study. Dear student, we came to know that it is time, it is high time, it is right time, it is proper time. After that, we have to use past simple tense or infinitive. And it was time, it was high time, it was proper time, it was right time. These are in past tense form. So we have to use past perfect tense or infinitive. Number 10, element years have passed since such a conjunction which has two parts or two clauses. If the previous clause is present tense, then you have to use past simple tense. If the previous part is past simple tense, then you have to use past perfect tense. 10 years have passed, subject plus have as verb third form. We are watching that this is present perfect tense. So that's been present tense. So you have to, we have to use past simple to incomplete this sentence. Since I lost my father. Years have passed, present perfect tense plus since plus past simple tense. If I use have subject plus verb second form, that's mean past simple tense. We know that past simple tense plus since, then we have to use past perfect tense. So, to complete this sentence, past simple tense plus since plus past perfect tense. Number 11, if you had phoned me, we know that it is a conjunction and this is called conditional conjunction. That means it is subordinate conjunction, that means subordinate clause, and subject plus head verb third form, third condition. We know that if plus past perfect plus would have, could have, might have, should have plus verb third form plus object. We have to complete this incomplete sentence by using these rules. If you had phoned me, I would have come, or I could have come, or I should have come. Number 12, I will help you providing that such a conjunction which previous part is future simple and the last part will be in present simple. Providing that we are watching the previous part of two words, that is future simple tense. So we have to complete this sentence in present simple tense. I will help you providing that. Providing that means if you want. Number 30, he had waited here before. We know that previous part of before is past perfect tense, and the end of the part or the last part of before must be in past simple tense. So we see that here the previous part of before, he had waited here. Subject plus adverb verb third form, that's been past perfect tense and before. So we have to complete this sentence in past simple tense. If we know that before and after, sometimes these are conjunction, sometimes these are preposition. If there is any clause before and after, then these are conjunction, otherwise preposition. Dear students, to complete any incomplete sentence, you must have good command over tense, voice, right form of verb, and use of conjunction. Otherwise, you will not be able to complete any incomplete sentence proper way. So, thanking you for being with me, and be connected with me always. And focus on next class. Assalamu alaikum.